My name is Keith Watkins. I'm a graduate student here at UNCG, working in the Carolina Tree Ring Science Laboratory. I've been coring these trees on campus to determine how old they are in relation to the school, and we found that some of the trees date back to 1840. All right, what we have here is a shortleaf pine tree on UNCG's campus, right out in front of Shaw Hall. You can kind of see on this tree that it's got a nice pronounced lean to it. That's a really good indicator of old age for us when we're looking for these trees. It tells us that it's been around for quite a long time and undergone a lot of droughts and a lot of years of excess rain. Right now we're coring into the tree using this increment borer, and it's going to create a straw-sized sample that I'm going to pull out of the tree. But it doesn't hurt it, don't worry. No more than a woodpecker might hurt it. What it's going to do is we're going in from the outside all the way to the center, which we call pith, and once it's out we're going to count the rings, so we're going to see how old this tree is. It's a lot like turning a lug nut on a car tire, trying to change those tires, but it's worth it when we get this information in the end. Close to 100. This on our champion tree, we're taking a look here. It's gone all the way back to 1891 and 1892, when the university was first established as the Women's College. You can take a look, you can see quite a bit of growth in these years, and it's pretty uniform. And you can go through here, we're going all the way back, getting up to 1900, right at the turn of the century. You can note these marks right there. That usually means 100 years has passed with a microscope. Right, we're getting through here into 1905, right, and we'll take a little jump here and we'll take a look at when the building itself was established, and that was in the 1950s, I believe. You can note some suppression here as we're going through the 1940s. This could have been a period of drought, or there could have been more construction on campus causing it to grow just a little bit less during those years. But you can kind of see it goes right back to normal in the 50s. And then right here, when you get to 1960, this is when the dorm was first being built, and this is a more strong dormitory. And you can kind of see here it was going pretty well after the suppression. It came back, bounced right back, and then it's coming in, and they're pretty narrow rings for those years when it was undergoing construction. All right, and we're going back through the 70s, okay, we're going through the 80s, and you can notice on here some years have really wide late wood, and some have very narrow late wood. And this tends to have a lot to do with the precipitation during the winter, and even the temperatures. And in the warmer years, the tree is going to undergo quite a bit of growth during the winter. But when you get really cold, dry winters, you're not going to get very much growth at all. So there's a lot of variation as you run through here. And we're getting into the 90s, 95, and this is 2000. All right, and we're bringing right back up to present. That'll be right around 2015 when this core was taken, or 2014.